reliability design. So what is comes under the reliability design? The reliability design is used to solve a problem with multiplicative optimization function. This is mainly used to solve a problem with multiplicative optimization problem. So the problem is designed a system that is composed of several devices. That means in there are many different devices. All the devices are connected. In that we are having the devices, in that all the devices are connected. And if you take in this one, each device is contain the one of the reliability. So that means if you take the device, the A contain the RI. RI represent the reliability. Each device must contain the reliability of the particular device. So the reliability is the probability of the device. I, if you are taking this RI, the RI is comes from the probability of the device I, and this is the one of the function, it will be the updates. And if you are taking the reliability of the entire system, the reliability of the entire system is written by the pi of R of I. The reliability of entire system is comes from the pi of R of I. Even if the individual device are very reliable, then the reliability of the overall system is, may not be reliable. So in that we can take this one. Suppose if you are having the multiple copies of the same device and are connected in parallel. They are taking the multiple devices of the same type and these are connected into the parallel. And these looks like a one switching circuit. If you are taking the switching circuit, how this must be specified? So that means in that if you are taking the device, you are having the different stages. Stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. After that, you are having the stage N. So each stage is having the sum of the devices. In that we are having the 3 devices. In that we are having the only 2 devices. And in that we are having the 3 devices. And in that we are having the n devices. So all are connected in the switching circuit. If you take in the switching circuit, how we are determine this? The switching circuit determines the which device in a given group are functioning properly. The switching circuit gives the which device within a group are functioning properly. If we want to identify this one, this must be having the each stage must be considered. After considering the stage, in that each stage must contain the MI copies. That means number of copies. So depending on the MI copies, in that we must take the one of the function. That function comes under the 1 minus RI whole power MI. In that you can take the one of the function. That function comes under the 1 minus RI whole power MI. So that must become under the, if you take the stage I, the stage I contains the MI copies. The stage I contains the MI copies. MI means number of copies of the any particular device DA. Then the probability that all the MI have function is 1 minus RI whole power MI. Hence the reliability of the stage I becomes the reliability of the stage. One minus RI whole power MI. So this is the main function. Using this main function, you can calculate the how we are having the reliability of the system. Okay. Next, let us assume that the reliability of the each stage I is given by the one of the function. That function is comes from the pi of I MI. So this is the reliability of the system at each stage. So in that I, so what is the company? I less than or equal to n. So now we can take the reliability of this system at stage. The reliability of the system of stages. So if you are taking all the stages, in this case, it will be coming from the pi of i. Mi. In that we will consider the pi of i mi. So the I must be 1 less than or equal to I less than or equal to n. So in that you are taking the all the L averages. Let in that you can take the let C of I. If you take the C of I upon the cost of each device. In that you can take the cost of each device is C. Next you can take the C. The C is comes under the maximum allowable cost. The C represents the maximum allowable cost of the system. After that, it is only the following maximization problem. If you want to solve the maximization problem, that must be comes under the maximize. The function is pi of i mi and 1 less than or equal to I less than or equal to n. So this is subject to, so what is the process here again? Sigma I equal to 1 to n or 1 less than or equal to I less than or equal to n. In that you can take the cost. So this is comes under the CIMI. The cost of each device and the MI. So this must less than or equal to C. In that we can take this one. So this is comes under the maximization of this process. And if you take this one, in that you can calculate the each C cost must be greater than 0. And they must be in the range of 1 to this CI. In that we can take this one. After taking that one, next you can calculate the upper bound of the each and every device. If you are taking the upper bound is represented by the E of I. The E of I is represented by the upper bound. So this upper bound is calculated by the equation C plus C of I. C means the total cost and C of I means the cost of each device minus sigma I equal to 1 to n Ci. That means in that you can take the total cost of all the devices by Ci. So for each device. So using that equation you can calculate that one. So this is equal to the Ci minus sigma Ci by Ci. So this is equal to the Ci minus sigma Ci by Ci plus 1. So you can use this upper bound equation and you can calculate the what is the reliability of the function. Let in that you are taking the one function, that is f of I x. The f of I x is represented by the sum of the function. The function must maximize the value. That value is comes under the pi of 1 less than or equal to I less than or equal to n. In that you are taking this pi of I m I. So this is one of the function you can take. And this subject to the function sigma 1 less than or equal to j less than or equal to n. In that you can take the cj mj. And if you take this one, the cj mj must be less than or equal to x value. So in that we can take the one of the function. After taking the function, next you can calculate the what is the optimal solution of this function. If you are calculating the optimal solution, that must be represented by the f1 of c. Optimal solution. So how to calculate the f1 of c? The f1 of c comes under the maximum of, so 1 less than or equal to m less than or equal to u. The maximum and upper bound. In that here in the function pi of n comma m of n. Pi of I m I. So in that case, you can take that one and f of n minus 1. In that case, I have the function I. In that, you can take this one into c minus a of n m of n. In that, you can take this. So this is the function you can use for the calculating the optimal solution. And if you take this one for any value, that means in that if you take the f of I, x of I. If you are taking any value f of I, x of I, in that I greater than or equal to 1. So this equals to the equation generalizes the what is the function of the f of I, x I. So the f of I, x I is similar to the this one. So clearly if you are taking this one, in that initially f of 0 x is 0. That means our f of 0 is equal to the f of 0 of x. If I take any value that is equal to the 1. So that means in that it is mainly depending on the probability. The probability is equal to the maximum probability is equal to the 1. So in that we can take this one. And in that if I take the 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to c. So in that we can take any function. Now you can take the s of I. If you take the s of I consists of the tuples of the values of the form f comma x. If you take any s of I is equal to the tuple of the form of the f of f comma x. Where if you take the f is called the f I of x. If you take the f I comes from the f I of x. So this is the values here considered for the tuple of values. Using the tuple of values, in that you can find out the sequence of dimensions. So what are the sequence of dimensions here having? You can identify the sequence of dimensions. So that means in that if you are taking the dimensions m1, m2 up to mn dimensions are existed. Then you can find out the functions of each and every one. That means in that you can determine the f1 of x1, f2 of x2. Like that you can identify the all the values of this functions. If you are identifying that one, in that they can follow the one of the rule f of 1 greater than the f of 2. That means in that you must follow the f of 1 greater than the f of 2 and x of 1 less than the x of 2. These two rules must be satisfied. After taking that one, if the rules are not satisfied, then they can discuss the form of tuple f comma x. So this is the process you can apply. If you have taken this process is called the dominated tuples. In that these are comes under the dominated tuples. The dominated tuples must be discarded. Okay, now we will discuss about the one of the example. In that example we are having the three devices. And each device contains the cost and the reliability. So D1 contains the 30 cost and 0.9 reliability. D2 contains the 15 cost and 0.8 reliability. D3 contains 20 cost and 0.5 reliability. And in that we are also having the total cost. The total cost is given by the C, that is 105. Okay, first of all we will decide the what of the upper limit of the each device. That means U of I. If you want to calculate the E of I, in that you are using the equation E of I equal to C minus sigma C I by C I plus 1. So this is the equation you can follow for that one. So first you want to find out the device U1, the first one. If you want to find out the total cost is 105 minus sigma C I, 30 plus 15 plus 20. 5065 by C1 means cost of 1 plus 1. If you are calculating this, this value is equal to the 2. Now you can calculate the U2. U2 means C means 105 minus 65 by C2 15 plus 1. So this is equal to 3. Next you can calculate the E3. The E3 equal to 105 minus 65 by D3, 20 plus 1. So this is equal to 3. So in that your calculator, the upper limit values, that means 2, 3, 3. So this is the process you are calculating that one. After calculating that one, next you want to calculate the what is the reliability of the cost. If you want to calculate the reliability, that is mainly depending on the s power of I value. Using the s power of I value, you can calculate the reliability. So initially you can take the first one, so s power 0. If you take the s power 0, the s power 0 is something like the 1 comma 0 only. So that means in that you are having the probability maximum 1, in that you are having the 1 comma 0. So after that you can calculate the what is the value of the s power 1, next s power 2, s power 3. In that you are having the 3 divisors. So in that case you can calculate the s power 1 and s power 2 and s power 3. Okay, first you can calculate the what is the process of the s power 1. If you want to calculate the s power, if you want to calculate the s power I, in that case this must use the value of s power I minus 1. It will use the s power I minus 1, using the s power I minus 1 value, in that you can calculate the s power I. Initially you can take the s power 0 equal 1 comma 0. Next you want to calculate the s power 1 of 1. So if you want to calculate that one, in that case you must use the function pi of I m I equal to 1 minus r I m I. So if m I of I is representing the what is the value of 1. So if you are taking this one, in that first you can calculate the d of 1. So in that upper limit is 2. That means in that you can take the 2 values. So in that if you are taking this one, 1 minus r I, r I means r 1. So 0.9 whole power 1. So that means this is equal to the 1 minus 0.1. So that is equal to the 0.9. The s power 1 of 1 equal to 0.9. So using that reliability and using the cost, you can calculate the s power 1 of 1. If you want to calculate the s power 1 of 1, in that must be used for the s power 0 of 1. So in that you are having the cost and reliability. You can multiply the cost and reliability of the s power 0 with the cost and reliability of s power 1. So that is the process. Okay, now in that you can take the reliability 0.9. The previous value s power 0 equal 1 comma 0. If you want to calculate the s power 1, in that case you can use the previous value of s power 0. So you need double r comma x, the reliability is multiplied with the previous reliability and the cost is added to the previous cost. In that previous reliability is 1 and previous cost is 0. So now in that we are having the reliability is 0.9 and cost is 30. So these are added to the previous one. So that means 1 into 0.9 comma 0 plus 30. Yeah. So that means this is comes under the 0.9 comma 30. So this is the value of 1. Now you can calculate the s power 1 of 2. So if you want to calculate the 1, in that case you must use the 1 minus 0.9 whole square. So mi. So initially mi equal to 1, in that mi equal to 2. Now you can calculate the value. Again, after taking the reliability, now you multiply this into the 2 into the cost. Now if you take this value is equal to the 0.99. So the 0.99 is multiplied with the this cost 1, and in that you can take the reliability in that s power 0 equal to 1 comma 0. So again you can use this one and multiply the 0.99 with the 1, and you can add the cost. If you want to add the cost, in that you are taking the 2c1, because this is the 2. So in this case you can take the 2 into 30, that is 60 is added to the 0. So that means in that it will become under the 1 into 0.99 comma 0 plus 60. So that means 0.99 comma 60. So this is the S1 of 2. After that you can calculate the what is the value of S1. So in that the upper limit is 2. So depending on that one you can calculate the S1 of 1 and S1 of 2 only. So now you can calculate the what is the value of the s power of 1. The s power 1 of 1 comes under the union of s power 1 of 1 plus union of s power 1 of 2. So in that if you take the s power of 1 of 1, this is the value of 0.9 comma 30 and another one is 0.99, 16. So the entire circle comes from the s power 1 of 1. Now you can calculate the s power 2, that means d2. After that s power 3, d3. So now you will calculate the divide 2, so s2 of 1. If you want to calculate this one, in that 1 minus 1 minus ri whole power 1, so ri is relativity 0.8. So this is the first divide, so in this case 1 minus 1 minus 0.8 whole power 1, so this is equal to 0.8. Then now we can multiply this with the s power 1. So in that s power 1, in that you have the two sets are registered. So first you can take the 0.9 into 0.8 comma, so the 30 plus you can add the cost of the divide 2. The cost of divide 2 is 15. So 30 plus 15. Next one is 0.99 into 0.8. And in that cost 60 plus 15. So this is the value of 0.72, 45 and 0.792, 75. Next you can calculate the S2 of 2. So in that the upper bound is 3. So in that case you can calculate the S2 of 1, S2 of 2, S2 of 3. So in that you can take the pi 2 of m2. So that means 1 minus 1 minus 0.8 whole power mi. Then mi value is 2. So this is equal to 0.96. Now you can add the 0.96 to the this S1. And the cost. So in that you can take the cost. The cost is equal to 2C2. So that means in that the cost is 15. That means 2 into 15, that is equal to 30. You can add the 30. So 0.9 into 0.96 comma 30 plus 30. Next 0.99 into 0.96 comma 60 plus 30. So this is equal to the 0.864 comma 60, 0.9504 comma 90. Next you can calculate the S3 of 3. So in that 1 minus 1 minus ri means 0.8 whole power 3. So this is equal to the 0.992. So again you can multiply this 0.992 to the s power 1. So in that terms you can take the cost. The cost is equal to 3 into C2. That means 3 into 15. That means 45. So in that the 0.9 into in that 0.992 comma 30 plus 45. Next 0.99 into 0.992 comma 60 plus 45. So the total cost is 0.8929 comma 75 and 0.98208 comma 105. So in that you can calculate the S2 of 2 value. If I take the S2 of value, in that case you can take the S2 of 1 union S2 of 2 union S2 of 3. So that means in that you can take the sets. The first one contains the 0.72 comma 45. Next 0.792 comma 75. This is the one set. Next one is 0.864 comma 60. Next one is 0.9504 comma 90. And third one is 0.8929 comma 75 comma 0.98208 comma 105. So that is comes under the S of 2. In that, if you are observing that, in that you are having the cost 45 greater than 75, next one greater than 60, 45 less than 60, less than 90, less than 75, less than 105. So this is not correct. 45, 75, 60, 90, 75, 105. In that, you must have the increasing order. So in that case, in that if you are taking this, observing this one 0.72, 0.792, 0.864, 0.95, 0.8929, like that you are having 0.98. So these must be in increasing order also. See, at the time in that you can take this one, this must be removed and this must be removed. The two are removed in this one. So after that the total setting comes under the 0.7245. 0.864, 60, 0.8929, 75, 0.98208, 105. So, I have done with 45, 60, 75, 105. This is the increasing order. 72, 86, 89, 98. These are also increasing order. say this is the final set S2. Now we will calculate the F3 value. So now calculate the S3 as 1. In that the reliability is 0.5. So 1 minus R whole power m means 1 minus 0.5 whole power 1. So that is equal to 0.5. Now you can add, multiply the 0.5 with the S power 2. So that means in the 0.72 into 0.5 and 45 plus the cost is 20. This 0.864 into 0.5 plus 60 plus 20. This 0.89928 into 0.5 comma 75 plus 20. 0.98208 into 0.5 plus 10520. If you're taking this one, in that we're taking the 0.36 comma 65, 0.432 comma 80, and 0.4465 comma 95. And in that I am discovering the last one because 105 plus 20, that is 125. But our total cost is 105 only. So in this case we will discard this one. Next S3 of 2. So 1 minus 0.5 whole power 2, that means 0.75. Again you can do the process 0.72 into 0.75, 45 plus 2 into cost, 2 into 20 is 40. 0.864 into 0.75 plus 60 plus 40 and 0.54 into. And next one is in that if you're taking this one, 75 plus 40. So this exceeds the 105 and 105 plus 40 also exceeds this. So I am removing that one. And the final values are 0.54, 85 and 0.648, 100. Just S3. 1 minus 0.4 over cube, that is 0.875. So in that we will consider the 0.72 into 875 plus 45 plus 2 into 3 into 20, 60. Next, if we are taking the 60 plus 60, 120, exceeds the total cost of 105. So we will discard all these ones. So in that we are having only 1.5, so that is the 0.63 comma 105. So after that you can calculate the S3 value. The S3 value is in S3 of 1 plus S3 of 2 plus S3 of 3. So if you are combining this one, you are having these values 0.3665, 0.4328, 0.4465, 0.5485, 0.64800 and 0.63105. In that 65, 80, 95, 85, 100, 105. So again you can apply the purge rule. So that means in that you can take the cost must be in increasing order. But in that 80 and 95 and 85. So in that 95 less than 85. So in that you can apply the purge rule and you can remove the, this one. So in that case here in the 0.36 comma 65, 0.432 80 and you are removing the 95 and the 85 and the 100 and in that you are also in the equal to total cost. So I am removing this one. So this is the F3. So in the D3 you are having the upper bound is 3. After that, in that we will identify the which one is the maximum reliability. In that the maximum reliability comes from the 0.64800. If you are taking the 0.64800, how we are having the 0.64800? So that must be comes under the F3. In F3 we are having the S2, 0.648 and 100. So that means you can add the 60 plus 40. So that means in F3 of 2 you are having the, this one. So in that 60, where you are having the 60? The 60 comes in the S2 in that. So the 60 comes from the previous value, S1 value, 30. So in that we can take the S1, S2, S3. So in that we can identify the what is the maximum reliability you are having. So this is the process of the reliability of the our given design.